That's what I would recommend. Sana product that humble standpoint, you know, that if we want to experience the joy of God's strength, we must not rely on human strength, but the strength of God at work in us despite our shortcomings and failures. Yes.
Are you Franciscan?
No. I am a diocesan. A diocesan educated by the Jesuits. Makes it worse.
And we have bishops talking about St. Francis, Bishop John.
Are you Franciscan yourself?
Yes.
Wow, you're a Franciscan here.
Christian people group, only 0.3%. Even my diocese of Okinawa is 0.45%. Very small number of Christianity. So, just we're talking about joy, very important joy. How the church bring that is joy, because my diocese of Okinawa, I invited MS Philippine missionary, and I invited sister from Cotabato, Cardinal Kedelos, three missionary sisters, and the lay missionary, Filipino lay missionaries.
Yes.
Also, my diocese is a Filipino group in the community.
Yes.
They really but in Japan, most Christians, not enough, have joy. So,
what is the problem of joy?
So,
it's more fun in the Philippines, no? I'm sure you're also joyful people.
Yes. Yes, it's sad. I am bringing you to my country.
How did I learn to be joyful? Is that the question? Yeah. Yes. Did I learn it? Yes. I think I experienced it. And you know, from so deep in the Word of God, I think my source of joy is in the Word of God. In my parish, in Borgosin Parish, in Amelie City, we started a little formation program. We call it Be Fast. Be Fast. We're inviting people to be fast. You know, it's a fast-paced society nowadays. And we ask, you know, teachers questions like, do you want to be fast in understanding God's Word? Do you want to be fast in discovering God's Word? Do you want to be fast in recovering from loss and failure in your life? Come and join the Be Fast. And the Be Fast in our parish is Bible for Faith and Action Sharing Team. It's the action arena. We bring people together, groups of 5 to 7 individuals. Put up a cell group. You know, we ask people to imagine themselves as living cells in the body of Christ. No, your membership into Christ is not as individuals, but as cell groups, as cells. You have to be bonded together, where 2 or 3 are gathered together in my name, says the Lord, there I am in the midst of them. Bring people and let their bonding be around the Word of God. When people can pray together around the Word of God, I think they will experience the joy of the gospel. Thank you.
Right now, the Pope keep asking the whole church to reform, to renew, and to repent. Because it's acknowledged that in our own structure of the clergyman, the structure of the church, sometimes I'm not with the love of the evangelist. And so, 2 days ago, Father Rocky, he shared with us how we dismantle the sense of comfort,
yes.
The sense of spirit,
yes.
To be able to risk everything,
yes.
To become the messenger or the witnesses of joy.
Yes.
And what kind of dismantle we see at the whole church, at the church of Philippines, needs to dismantle in order to become truly the messenger of the witnesses of the gospel joy to the culture here, but and also to the whole world. Because I see a lot of people are now keep looking outside, but looking inside our two kind of mission.
Yes.
Inwardly and outwardly. Inwardly, I think sometimes very difficult as a witness of joy.
Yes.
Sometimes when we work together, it's different. People have a different kind of views, like the old kind,
yes.
of proclaiming the gospel.
Yes.
And sometimes those people are more, so if you are a few of a minority, and sometimes you sense that resistance, and that resistance sometimes prevents from feeling the support of the community, and sometimes feeling alone in struggling for the joy of the gospel.
You said that so well. Thank you. Well, you know, many of our structures and institutions in the church are still effective, but some are getting a bit antiquated, you might call that, or even petrified, you know. And once we allow ourselves to petrify, we begin to lose the joy in us. We might just be maintaining our structures and institutions, you know, which are good, you know, because we inherited them. Not bad, you know. But I think one of the important elements or formula for reinfusing newness into the church is by involving the children and the youth. Because and I'm going to share that actually this afternoon. You're anticipating my homily. If you make the church for adults only, you are killing the church. Amen. Thank you.
It's one more.
One more.
Thank you. You were allowed to share yesterday,
yes.
Regarding the non-Muslim people. And in Taiwan, we have a lot of
non-Muslim,
a lot of minorities.
Yes.
And sometimes, how do we really integrate them into the mainstream? And I think that's very important because when I listen to their story, I think
yes.
Maybe we need more to make them
yes.
Our teachers to let them experience joy.
Yes.
They're suffering a lot.
Yes. Thank you. You know, I appreciate your question, but the big question is how do we integrate? It's what I mean. I'm sure you mean when you say how do we integrate them. Being a mountain people also where I come from, they are called Aitas. They're, you know, black, they live out in the mountains. And you know why they live in the mountains? Because the lowlanders drove them to the mountains and claimed their lands in the lowlands, you know. Anyway, that's another story altogether. But when you say integrate, I think you're well-meaning, but you're forgetting. You might be forgetting something. Before we try to attempt to integrate, perhaps we should first accept their particularity as ethnic communities, appreciate, you know, their cultural identity, and, you know, embrace them, invite them. It's by invitation, not by obligation. Evangelize by attraction, and not by imposition. I think that's a formula of Pope Francis.
Round of applause for Bishop and Lord Levy. Before we